What's going on, everybody? I am back to break down this 9-game MLB DFS slate on DraftKings and FanDuel. Excited to get into it. We're going to be giving you guys the top plays to get you in that green cash line tonight. As always, if you enjoy the content, would be greatly appreciated if you hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future content that I upload. If you are getting very serious about MLB DFS, I would highly recommend my MLB DFS premium packages. I haven't been able to make these videos as of much lately, so I don't even know if people are aware of this, but we're still grinding over here on the premium stuff. I do offer a Prize Picks MLB package as well as a DraftKings FanDuel MLB package. And if you do play DraftKings FanDuel and Prize Picks, go and check out the MLB combo package. But the DraftKings FanDuel package is really good stuff, guys. Go and check it out. You're going to get my core plays, my cheat sheet, my top stacks, my daily sheets, hot hitter stack cast, team hitting data, bullpen data, all of that fun stuff. So I've been getting a lot of good feedback on the premium content from current members. Winning some money, and unfortunately, I haven't been able to make these videos quite as much as I'd like to. I'm trying to get used to this. I'm doing a lot more on the prop side. The DraftKings FanDuel is the original, though, so I know a lot of people have been missing these videos. If you did miss the video, like I said, hit the like button, but leave a comment down below. Say you like this content so I can produce more of it. Just let me know that you really do like it. Helps me to figure out, you know, what people are really looking for me to produce. But without further ado, let's get into it. We're going to talk about it. As always, I like to go ahead and sort my sheet by K rate. It's fantasy sports. We get points for strikeouts. Figure out the top pitchers on the slate that we want to play, and then we'll break down bats on this latter half of the video. And I will give you my home run call of the day at the end of the video as well. Forgot to mention that. So make sure you stay tuned to that. The top guy is going to be George Kirby taking on the New York Mets tonight. He does have a very limited sample size, though. We're only talking about a 6-innings pitch sample size for Kirby against this New York Mets squad. So take his data with a little bit of a grain of salt here. Because we really don't have that big of a sample size on him. So, unfortunately, he's someone that right off the bat, we can't really elaborate on too much. The only thing I want to talk about is he did have 7 Ks against the Tampa Bay Rays team. That is a very good offense overall in his debut here with 81 pitches. So, that's pretty good. And that might be, you know, a sign of life for him. But the problem is he gets to take on a New York Mets squad tonight. That's really just not an ideal matchup. They're a really difficult one. It's in City, which is a great ballpark for pitching, which is an upside thing for Kirby, but I kind of think he's a high-risk, high-reward option tonight. And then when you're looking at the New York Mets strikeout stuff up and down their lineup, they're not really exactly the heaviest Ks of lineup. They're definitely not the best, but I don't know. It's not a lineup that you can just feel comfortable targeting like a young guy and just feeling like, oh, yeah, he could have a good game no matter what here, such as some other teams that aren't so good in the league, so I think he's a valid tournament option, but just not exactly the top guy in the slate, even though the data says so, because it's such a small, limited sample size here. You know, can't really put that too much into account, but I do think he's worth a risk option in your tournament lineup. Shane Bieber is truly going to be the top option here with a 32.1% K rate overall, with a 15% swinging strike rate, and a 30.3% carry to righties, as well as a 34.1% carry to lefties. So just elite stuff across the board against both sides of the plate. He gets to take on a Minnesota squad tonight. That one, looking at their implied run total. It doesn't look like the Vegas lines are up yet, but there's 13 minor ones blowing out. He's in Minnesota, which is a pretty good pitching ballpark. So I think this could be matching up pretty well for Bieber. And then when you look at the pitch count and the recent results as far as how stretched out he is, last time he gave up 7 earned runs against the Toronto Blue Jays. So just got absolutely blown up, only threw 71 pitches, but times four, 101.05. So, I mean, the guys really stretched out. 7 and 6 Ks respectively in those two games. 3 earned run against the Angels, and then only 1 earned run against the Oakland Athletics. So, that is kind of what you're looking for out of a pitcher. You know, you can't ask for much more. You want the pitch count to be way up there. If we can get a long leash and a long start from him, that would be ideal. And then when you're looking at the K upside as far as taking on this Minnesota squad tonight, up and down their lineup, there are plenty of Ks. I mean, towards the bottom of the lineup, there's some low strikeout guys. Towards the bottom of the lineup, there's some high strikeout guys. Towards the top of the lineup, there's a couple of low strikeout guys. But for the most part, you know, you're looking at 26% out of a Buxton. Polanco does strike out 20% of the time. Sanchez, Kirilloff, Gordon, and Lewis all strike out 20%+ of the time as well. So should be plenty of strikeout upside here for Shane Bieber. Does look like he's going to be definitely one of the top options. Another guy that I have a lot of interest in, we'll just jump right down to him, is going to be Zach Allen taking on the Chicago Cubs. The Cubs have a ton of strikeouts in their bats. He has a 27.3% carry overall with a 30% carry to righties and a 24.6% carry to lefties. The strikeout rate does dip down a lot to those lefties. And honestly, him and Christian Javier have very similar statistics here, so we can kind of talk about both these guys together. But the matchup definitely goes to Zach Allen because the Chicago Cubs have just been striking out a ton Looking up and down their lineup. So they're a team that I'm definitely looking to target for upside out of my pitchers in my tournament lineup. Zach Gallen's a 161 favorite here. And like I said, some of these guys just, I mean, Suzuki, 34% K rate, Happ, 27%, Contreras, 28%, Rivas, 32%, Patrick Wisdom, 38%. And then the bottom of the line, guys are all 20%+ K rate as well. So literally every single guy in this lineup has a 20%+ K rate outside of Rafael Ortega at the top of the lineup, and he has a 17% K rate. So I think there's a lot of strikeout upside here for Zach Gallen. Definitely someone that I'm going to want to be having some interest in. And then when you look at Christian Javier, like I said, I mean, he's really good against righties when it comes to Ks, but against lefties, not so much. He does give up a lot of fly balls, but the hard contact stuff's not that bad. So a little bit of conflicting numbers when it comes to him. But when you look at the Washington Nationals lineup up and down, as far as how many righties and lefties they're expected to roll out, is pretty mixed for the most part, but I mean, there's only expected to be one, two, three righties in there. So, I mean, the switch hitters kind of make up for the right-handed splits that Christian Javier has. And then when you look at the strikeout stuff, I mean, that for me might be the exact factor that kind of puts Zach Gallen ahead of him. Zach Gallen, as far as his leash and everything, and his pitch count recently, similar to Shane Bieber that we just talked about. I mean, he's up there in the 90s to 100 pitches, 90, 102, 92 pitches. So everything you're looking for out of a pitcher, I think he's going to be one of the top options on the slate tonight for sure. And then you have Julio Urias taking on the Philadelphia Phillies. Once again, a very good pitcher up and down. Limits the hard contact. Has a decent amount of K stuff, but the Phillies do strike out quite a bit. So that should be able to help him, his case out here against this Philadelphia Phillies team tonight in LA. He's a 185 favorite, so expected to get that win. The quality start. They're listing Garrett Clevenger here on the starting lineup page, a little bit conflicting. For those that don't know, I use the DraftKings starting pitchers, probable starters, when I make these videos because, for the most part, they tend to be the most accurate. I mean, they do a pretty good job. So I'm anticipating that's going to be Julio Urias tonight. The only problem with him is the pitch count. He really does not have the highest of pitch counts compared to some of these other guys. So for me, he's going to be, you know, he's not really at the top of my list for that reason. He looks good, all the numbers match up, but I want a guy that can go deep into the game. I don't have to worry about the pitch count. We kind of already talked about a lot of those guys. And then jumping down to Michael Lorenzen, he gets one of the best matchups you could ask for, taking on the Oakland Athletics. He's going to be looking really good. I think Chris Bassett's another guy you could be looking to. I don't mean to skip over him. So he's taking on the Seattle Mariners. We'll talk about him first, I guess. 23.7% K rate overall. He has a 22.5% K rate to righties and a 25.1% K rate to lefties. The Seattle Mariners really aren't the most talented lineup in the league. And he does get the pitch in city tonight in New York. I mean, I talk about these ballparks oftentimes. And I like to pull up the diagram to give you guys an exact idea. City Field, see a lot of red going on as far as a hitting environment. So it is a great pitching ballpark. So everything kind of matching up for him there. Once again, a guy that should have a pretty long leash. He's actually priced up the most on these websites. Has had a fantastic season at this point. 98, 97, 94, 95, 101 pitches. So another guy that I would certainly be willing to get some exposure to in my lineups tonight. And then I talked about Michael Lorenzen. He gets just one of the best matchups you could ask for, taking on an Oakland Athletics squad that is just horrendous up and down their lineup. So that's automatically going to make him a candidate to be in my lineups. I mean, Oakland's definitely a lineup that I like picking on. They only have a 3.17 implied run total. He's a 190 favorite. It's in Oakland, which is a great pitching ballpark. Pulling up that diagram as far as the Oakland A Coliseum. See a lot of red going on. Outfield, not good. Home runs, not good. Hitting weather, not good. It's only 73 degrees out there tonight compared to some of these other spots we're going to talk about that are like in the 80s or around 80. So it could be worse for sure. There's some other spots that are even colder, but you factor in the lineup talent as well with this Oakland Athletics squad. It's just not good, man. A lot of strikeouts. Pache, 34% at the bottom of the lineup. Then you work your way up. 26% for Smith. 17-17. 30% for Ramon Laureano. Seth Brown strikes out 27% of the time. News strikes out 30% of the time. So lots of strikeouts. And then lastly, the leash, the pitch count that we keep talking about as far as how he's been doing. He's been right up there around 93, 189 pitches. So definitely another guy that checks all the boxes for me tonight that you could be taking a look to. And I kind of think that sums up the pitching for the most part. I mean, as I continue to go throughout my day and do my research, there might be a few more guys. But I think we did a pretty good job of summing up the top options here tonight that I'm certainly going to be taking a look to. We have Germán Márquez against the Royals in Coors if you want to go with him as a low-owned option. It does have a decent amount of strikeout upside stuff, but I mean, it's in Coors Field. That's obviously really scary. The pitch, it really just isn't as effective in Coors Field, but there are quite a few strikeouts in this Royals lineup for the most part. So he's just kind of an honorable mention, I guess you would say, but the Royals still do have a 4.67 implied run total. So just keep that in mind. But let's go ahead and swap on over to bats. As always, I like to go ahead and sort my sheet by Sierra skill and our active ERA. It's a good way of determining how good a pitcher's been in the past, how good they're expected to be in the future. I got this data lined up to the 2019-22 seasons. And the worst guy on the slate is going to be Adam Oller. Very limited sample size. He only has a 9 innings pitch sample size, but so far just really has not been good. He gives up a 667 slugging to righties, an 857 slugging to lefties. Once again, those numbers are based off 9 innings pitch, so take that with a grain of salt. But at the same time, sometimes you can kind of jump on these guys early. I mean, if this guy is just not going to be good, the Athletics, not really a good team overall, so they don't really have a lot of good going on. Maybe just stack up him and against him and then get that Oakland Athletics bullpen. Obviously, the hitting environment is terrible. We just talked about that, so that's less than ideal. But it could be a loan stack that could pay off. Either on the road, they get the guaranteed top of the ninth at bats. So Taylor Ward, Mike Trout, Otani, obviously you can hit the ball out of any ballpark. Those two guys, Anthony Rendon, Jared Walsh, Brandon Marsh. I mean, there's a lot of other worse stacks on the slate. So just mention that real quick. Obviously, we would prefer better hitting weather and all that stuff. We have Carlos Hernandez taking on the Colorado Rockies. He gives up a 34.3% hard contact rate, a 433 slugging to righties, and a 358 slugging to lefties. So his numbers are really bad, and he's in Coors Field, the number one hitting environment in baseball. Pulling up the diagram as far as Coors is concerned in Colorado, you can see all green. Home runs, the triples, the doubles, the singles. The weather's starting to warm up now finally, 79 degrees. The Rockies have a 5.83 implied run total, and they should definitely be, you know, one of your top stacks that you're looking to get some exposure to tonight. The guy's really bad against both sides. He is worse against righties, I will mention, but overall, just doesn't scare us. He doesn't strike anyone out. The ball's going to be put in play early and often. The hard contact stuff's not good. The ground ball fly ball stuff's not good. So targeting all the top talented hitters makes a lot of sense. Connor Joe, Charlie Blackman, CJ Cron has a bunch of power. Ryan McMahon, Randall Grichik, Brendan Rodgers, Hilliard, Iglesias, and Nunez at the bottom of the lineup are obviously, you know, a little bit less than ideal, 7, 8, and 9 hitters, but you can get some lower ownership on them and get exposure to the stack, and maybe they have a big game, and that launches you to the top of the leaderboard. So stacking up the Rockies 1 through 9, certainly going to be a valid option tonight. We have Eric Fetty taking on the Houston Astros. He has really good ground ball, fly ball stuff, but his Sierra is really bad because he does give up quite a bit of slugging. He doesn't really strike anyone out. I just really don't like stacking. That's a guy with good ground ball, fly ball stuff is the problem. Like, unless you're just banking on the Astros having such a big game that they get to the Nationals bullpen, which honestly, in this case, I do think is valid. Because if they can work the pitch count on Fetty and then they get to that bullpen, not scared of the Nationals bullpen whatsoever. They can definitely rack up some runs and then do get a nice ballpark here in Washington. Pretty great hitting environment. See the diagram. Lots of green going on across the board. So good home run hitters ballpark. The only problem is the weather right now looks like it could be a little bit dicey. So keep your eyes on the weather report. If you don't follow me over there on Twitter, at @KJK_DFS, I would highly recommend you do that. I'll tweet out, you know, a bunch of updates to help you guys out whenever possible on weather and a bunch of other stuff. So, but the Astros have a 5.06 applied run total. Like I said, Fetty doesn't really strike anyone out. It's just the ground ball, fly ball stuff. But I think I'd be willing to make an exception because the Astros have a talented lineup. He does give up quite a bit of slugging to lefties overall and righties. And the fact of the matter is if they can just work the pitch count and get to the bullpen, could be a really good stack, so I definitely would be willing to stack them up here. Altuve, Brantley, Bregman, Yordan Alvarez, Kyle Tucker, just absolutely loaded 1 through 5. And then Yariel Diaz, McCormick, and Maldonado is a pretty good 6 through 9 as well. So feel comfortable stacking the whole team. Sometimes I feel comfortable stacking the whole team. Sometimes there's like a cutoff, so I always mention that. Some people are like, you named every hitter on the team. Well, that's because I actually think you could play all of them. Sometimes I don't really think you can. Like sometimes I look at the bottom lineup and it's just, I mean, you can always play them, but you need some sort of power, some sort of talent. So, Griffin Jacks taking on the Cleveland Guardians, really bad numbers, a 40.1% hard contact rate, 50.2% fly ball rate. That is dreadful. Doesn't strike anyone out. Gives up a 539 slugging to righties and a 503 slugging to lefties. So he is not good. Cleveland Guardians are in a really good spot here if he is indeed the one that they're going to be taking on tonight. Once again, we have conflicting reports on the starting pitcher here, but from what I can see on DraftKings, they do have him listed as the probable starting pitcher. And once again, they've been really good at nailing those pitchers, so I expect that it's going to be Griffin Jacks here. And the Guardians are just going to be in a fantastic spot. This guy's numbers are really bad. The fact that he has a better Sierra than some of these other guys we're discussing really surprises me, to be quite frank. But regardless, I look at the underlying metrics and the hard contact's really bad to both sides. I love the Guardian stack tonight. They're on the road. Miles Straw, Stephen Kwan, Jose Ramirez, Owen Miller, Omar Rosario, Framel Reyes. I mean, there's a lot of other better talented lineups out there, but maybe that keeps their ownership lower than it should be. And when there's a pitcher that has this bad of numbers against both sides of the plate, this bad of numbers with the fly ball, the hard contact, I just don't care. There's major league hitters on the other side. They may not be the best, but these numbers are really, really bad. So I'd be willing to stack up those Guardians tonight for sure. Dallas Keuchel taking on the New York Yankees. He has really good ground ball, fly ball stuff. The Yankees are one of the hottest lineups in baseball. He gives up a 435 slugging to those righties against lefties. He's a lot better, but at this point, I think you could stack the Yankees up against anyone. They have a 4.67 implied run total. I mean, there's wind blowing in from left, which is less than ideal, but outside of that, it's a really great spot here for the New York Yankees. And the ground ball, fly ball stuff makes it a little bit scary as well, but kind of similar to an Eric Fetty that we talked about. You're just looking for them to work the count, get him out of the game, get to that bullpen, score some runs early on so you get some less talented bullpen arms in there. And that's how you're going to kind of benefit from the stack. But for the most part, you're looking to target the right-handed power. So Judge, Stanton are going to be the top premier options in the stack. Josh Donaldson, you round things out with Gleyber Torres, DJ LeMahieu. You could throw in the lefty with Anthony Rizzo to get a little bit more contrarian in your stack. People don't like playing lefty on lefty bats. So certainly no issues with that. And Anthony Rizzo does hit left-handed pitching very well. So Yankee stack definitely going to be viable. Certainly not afraid to be going to that one. We have Kyle Hendricks taking on the Arizona Diamondbacks. He's a guy that's pretty splits heavy. He does a good job of keeping the ball on the ground against those right-hand hitters, but against lefties, not so much. He gives up a 432 slugging against those lefties, so I do prefer to target him with some left-handed power, and the Arizona Diamondbacks have a bunch of lefties in their lineup. They're in Arizona, which is one of the best ballparks down that right field line to be targeting left-handed power, so everything matching up for the Diamondbacks lefties tonight. You can see down the right field line, lots of green going on, so stacking up these Arizona lefties makes a lot of sense to me. Varsho, Pavin Smith, David Peralta, Rojas, Marte, Seth Beer, Perdomo, and Alec Thomas. They literally have all lefties in the lineup outside of Christian Walker, and obviously I'm not afraid to play him either. It's a little bit less than ideal. I do prefer to target the lefties, but not afraid to play him. Rich Hill taking on Texas. He's pretty simple. You target him with right-handed power against lefties. He's much more effective, so the Rangers' right-handed bats are the ones you're really going to be looking to play. Tonight, if you are looking to stack up those Rangers in Texas, it is a great pitching environment, or I'm sorry, hitters environment. Expect to be Rich Hill and then switch over to Tanner Houck, though. So just keep that in mind. But Marcus Semien, Andy Ibanez, Adolis Garcia are going to be looking really good. Nick Solak, Eli White, Charlie Culberson, and all those guys actually hit left and pitching very well. So maybe Texas could be a low on stack that you're looking to go to tonight. Lorenzen taking on Oakland. I already talked about them. I don't want to target Oakland at all. They're just bad. Chris Bassett taking on Seattle, pretty much same thing. Herman Marquez taking on the Royals. They're in Coors Field, so they're always going to be a viable candidate. Definitely do prefer to target him with left-handed hitting, though. He's much better against those right-handed hitters. He has good K stuff. Ground ball, fly ball stuff's good. The lefties, it does dip down. So if I'm targeting the Royals, I do prefer the left-handed bats here in Coors. So, you know, loading up on some Benintendi, some Santana, but they're mostly a right-handed heavy lineup, which kind of makes me think Marquez is a good tournament option. That's what I talked about earlier. Obviously, it's less than ideal. It's a little bit scary. It's in Coors Field. You know, there's a lot of better situations he could be in, but the pitch count is extended. He has pitched at Coors for a while. He traditionally has pitched pretty good at home. I mean, he just put up a pretty good performance against the Philadelphia Phillies. 400 runs, 5 strikeouts, 90 pitches. Obviously, we would want a better performance than that, but I'm just saying, that's not terrible. He got the strikeouts. He went deep into the ball game. And if he's just able to, you know, not give up those runs, go deep in the ballgame, that's everything you're asking for out of a starting pitcher. He's a 162 favorite. I do expect the Rockies to score a lot of runs regardless of what the Royals do. So I think he gets some run support there as well. So everything adding up there. And then the rest of these guys, I'm really not all too intrigued to be targeting for the most part. I mean, just to do a quick little rundown of the overall slate, make sure we're not missing any high team totals, because obviously Vegas is, you know, very good at what they do. We can dig into that data a little bit more, but I think we pretty much touched on everyone. I mean, the Diamondbacks, the Rockies, the Royals, the Angels has a low on stack. The Dodgers would be the last one, I guess, that we did leave out, but Ranger Suarez is a really good ground ball, fly ball stuff. I just really don't like targeting Ranger Suarez. The Dodgers just have a really good lineup, so they're automatically kind of have a high implied run total. The Phillies bullpen is really bad, so I would assume that that's more so the case of why the Dodgers have a decent implied run total rather than targeting Ranger Suarez. So overall, as a stack, I just don't think they're that appealing. He definitely does struggle more so against righties and lefties, but even righties, he's really, really good at keeping the ball on the ground, limiting the hard contact. But targeting a low on Dodger stack is always going to be viable. I would just prefer the righties. Trey Turner, you know, Will Smith, Mookie Betts, Justin Turner, really, Chris Taylor, and then the lefties. Don't leave them out of your stacks because you can stay contrarian and they can still hit home run off the the bullpen arms, but I just don't think it's the best spot. Ranger Suarez just really does a good job of limiting the fly balls and limiting the hard contact. So that is my overall breakdown of this slate today. Before I let you guys go, of course, as always, I got to give you my home run call of the day. Let's get into it. And my home run call of the day today is going to be Jose Ramirez taking on Griffin Jacks. We mentioned his hard contact issues and overall terrible numbers across the board, especially against left-handed hitting. He only strikes out left-handed hitters at a 17.2% clip. He's up a 46.2% fly ball rate with a 5.03 slugging, 42% hard contact rate, and a 3.65 wOBA. Being played in Minnesota tonight, 13 mile an hour winds blowing out to center, 72 degrees, and the right field line does play friendlier to those left-handed hitters. Then lastly, when you're factoring what Jacks goes to, is mostly reliant on the fastball. He will mix in the slider, changeup, curveball, but I'm not too worried about that either. Ramirez profiles very well here, especially against the fastball, which he will go to the most here, 45% against left-handed hitting. A 92-93 mile an hour fastball. Jose Ramirez features a 569 ISO with a 527 wOBA against that pitch. Love this spot for Jose Ramirez. Get him in your lineups because he is my home run call of the day. So there we go, guys. Jose Ramirez, get him in your lineups. I think he takes Jacks deep tonight. And that is all from me in this one. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you don't miss any future content that I upload. And if you haven't checked out the premium content packages, would highly recommend you check them out. Patreon.com/KJK_DFS. That's linked below in the description. And if you haven't signed up for Prize Picks, check them out as well. Sponsor the program. Use that promo code KJKDFS to receive an instant match deposit up to $100. So it's all for me. Wish you guys all the best of luck tonight on your DFS slates, and we will see you in the next one.